Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how you can easily run C program in your Visual Studio Code. So let's begin. Now to run C program in your Visual Studio Code itself, you need to first download two software. One is MinGW compiler and another is Visual Studio Code itself. To download these two software, let us first go to our favorite browser, that is this Chrome browser itself. And in the address bar, just simply type MinGW distro, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this MinGW distro is basically our first search result. So just simply click on that and you'll be getting this official site of MinGW distro. In here, if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be getting these two links. One is MinGW 17.1 exe and another is MinGW 17.1 without git exe. So we are basically going to proceed with this MinGW 17.1 without git.exe. So just, you know, simply click on that and it will, you know, going to start downloading our MinGW itself. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. Right. So in this way, you can easily download MinGW compiler. I'll be also putting this link in the description. Right. So now it's time to download our Visual Studio Code itself. So for that, just simply type Visual Studio Code, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this code.visualstudio.com is basically our first search result. So, you know, just click on Visual Studio Code. And this will, you know, going to redirect you to this official site of Visual Studio Code. In here, you need to just simply click on Download for Windows. And this will, you know, going to start downloading our Visual Studio Code. You can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started downloading our Visual Studio Code. So just simply cancel it since I have already downloaded it. Just simply minimize it. And if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see our MinGW 17.1 without git has been, you know, rightly downloaded. And our another software, that is this Visual Studio Code, has been also downloaded over here. Now it's time to install these two software. So first we are going to install MinGW. So for that, just simply double click on it. And this is going to open this window. In here, entry, just simply click on this triple dot. Then scroll down a bit and then just simply select this local disk C. Then okay. Then just simply click on extract. And this is going to start extracting our MinGW compiler. So this might take a couple of minutes. So what I will be doing is I'll be coming back after installing our MinGW. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now as you can see, our MinGW has been rightly extracted. So if you just simply go to this C drive, you'll be getting this MinGW folder. So just simply go inside that folder and you can clearly see all files has been rightly extracted over here. Right. So just, you know, simply go inside this bin folder. Then just simply click on this address bar, then right click on it and copy. So we are basically going to copy this mingw/bin folder location. Then just simply click on the search icon and in here just simply type environ. Then just, you know, simply click on this edit the system environment variables. And then you'll be getting the system properties. In here you'll be getting this environment variables button. So just simply click on that and then under this user variables, just simply click on path, then edit, then new, then right click on it and paste. So we are basically going to paste that bin folder location over here. Then just simply click on OK, then again OK, then again OK. And now if you just simply click on this command prompt and here if you just simply type gcc space dash dash version, then enter. You can clearly see our GCC version 9.2.0 has been, you know, rightly installed over here. So all this basically mean is our MinGW compiler has been rightly installed. So just simply cancel it. And now it's time to install our Visual Studio Code itself. So here is our Visual Studio Code installer. So just simply double click on it to basically start installing our Visual Studio Code. And you can clearly see our license agreement has been rightly shown over here. So just simply accept this license agreement, then just simply click on next. And this is going to be our installation destinations. Keep everything as a default and then just simply click on next. And now it's telling that they're going to create this Visual Studio Code folder. So I am okay with it. Then just simply click on next. Now It's telling that whether we like to create a desktop shortcut icon. I'd like to check that. And this is a very important step. You need to add to path. You need to check this add to path. That's a very important step, right? So do check that. And then just simply click on next. And now it's telling that it's ready to be installed. So just simply click on install. And you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started installing our Microsoft Visual Studio code. This might take a couple of minutes. So what I will be doing is I'll be coming back after installing Microsoft Visual Studio code. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see our Microsoft Visual Studio code has been, you know, rightly installed, and our launch Visual Studio code button has also been checked. So just, you know, simply click on finish. And this will, you know, going to launch our Microsoft Visual Studio code. So as you can clearly see, our Microsoft Visual Studio code has been lightly launched over here. In here, you need to just, you know, simply click on file, then open folder. So our open folder window has been, you know, rightly opened. Here you need to just simply click on documents. And here we are basically going to write our C program, right? So for that, let us first create a folder itself. So C, we are going to write C program, right? So C progs. So just, you know, simply select that folder, and you can clearly see our C progs folder has been rightly selected over here. Right, now it's time to install a plugin. So for that, you need to just simply click on these extensions. And in here, you need to just simply type C/C++. And you'll be getting the C/C++ link over here. And here, you need to just simply, you know, simply click on install. Since I have already installed, it is showing that uninstalled. So here, it will, you know, show you install button. So you need to just, you know, simply install that. Right, and then you'll be getting this uninstall. So since I have already installed, I'll just, you know, simply go back to our Explorer, and here I am going to, you know, just simply click on this icon called new file. So just simply click on that, and let's create a new file called prog.c. Since we are writing a C program, so I am going to, you know, just simply give a file extension as .c, then enter. And you can clearly see our prog.c file has been created over here. Here I am going to write a simple hello world C program. So hash include stdio.h. And then I'm going to, you know, simply create a main method. So int main. And here I'm going to, you know, just simply print hello world. Hello world. Right. And then I also need to return a zero since I created int main. But see, it is showing some error. If you just hover over it, you can clearly see it is telling that include errors detected. So all this basically mean is we need to set our MinGW path over here. So for that, just simply click on quick fix, and then just simply click on edit include path settings. And this is going to open this C++ configurations window. Here, if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be getting this compiler path. So here, if you just simply click on this drop down icon, you'll be getting this GCC.exe. So just, you know, simply click on that and give some time to basically install this. And now if you go back to our C program, you can clearly see the error is gone, right? So now just simply go to file and save. So save this file, then go to terminal, then just, you know, simply click on run build task. And then you need to just simply select this GCC. And here you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started building our program that we have written. So it has, you know, rightly finished. And here under this explorer, you can clearly see this prog.exe file has also been created over here. So all this basically mean is our program has been, you know, successfully executed. Now it's time to run our program, right? And now in the terminal, if you see, it's telling that terminal will be diffused by tasks. So just, you know, simply press any key to close it. So just, you know, simply press any key from your keyboard and our terminal is going to be closed. So now if you just again go to terminal, then just, you know, simply click on this new terminal. And now if you just, you know, simply type this executable file name, that is prog. So just, you know, simply type prog But before that, you need to also set this dot slash. So dot slash basically mean is we're going to execute this proc.exe from this folder location itself. So dot slash proc, then enter. And now you can clearly see this hello world has been, you know, rightly shown in our console. So this hello world rightly shown. So what are the steps? You need to first install this plugin, then write a simple program. So after that, you might be getting some error. So that error will be coming only one time. All right. So for that, you need to just simply set this configuration compiler path over here to GCC, and then just, you know, simply go to terminal, then just simply run build task. And after that, press any key to close it, then go to terminal, create a new terminal, and then write the executable file that is created, that is this proc.exe. So you need to just, you know, simply give that extension first, dot slash. That means we are basically going to execute that file that is lying inside the same directory. So dot slash basically means that, right? And then proc basically this executable file that is created. So just, you know, simply do that much and you'll be getting this hello world in our console. That is basically this printf, what is what we are doing, right? So in this way, you can easily run C program in your Visual Studio Code itself using this MinGW compiler. I have almost shown you everything, right? So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.